Good day to you from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's now outline the clinical trial and approval stages of drug discovery. Before clinical trials can begin, the drug company or sponsor of the trial must gain permission to test its lead molecule in humans. The sponsor files an Investigational New Drug Application, or IND, to the FDA. The IND application includes information such as what preclinical or animal data has been collected and how the substance will be tested in humans. The IND application requires about a month, 30 days. The investigational new drug then enters phase 1 clinical trials. Phase 1 trials are performed on around 50 healthy volunteers. Phase 1 trials require several months to complete and answer questions like, is the drug safe for humans? Does the molecule cause adverse drug reactions? Note that side effect does not have regulatory meaning. The accepted term is adverse drug reaction. Or simply ADR. Another question, at what dose are adverse drug reactions observed? Safety is the top priority for phase 1 trials. Information from phase 1 trials will help in the design of phase 2 trials. Subjects in phase 2 trials are no longer healthy volunteers. They are patients who have the condition that is treated by the drug candidate. Phase 2 trials, while still focused on safety, determine the dose at which the molecule is effective. Phase 2 trials involve around 200 patients and require a year or longer. The exact numbers vary considerably. Once dosing has been determined in phase 2, phase 3 trials enroll thousands of patients. Phase 3 trials look at both safety and efficacy. Because phase 3 trials involve many patients, the sponsor can explore how the molecule affects people of different ages, ethnicities, genders, health, etc. Phase 3 trials are long and can require several years. If satisfied with the trial data, the sponsoring company compiles a dossier on the drug candidate. The dossier covers all aspects of the drug program: clinical trials, preclinical data, how the molecule is synthesized and formulated into its dosed form, and drug package design. The dossier is huge. The dossier is submitted as a new drug application. Formally, the NDA step alone is the approval step. The FDA strives to review NDAs within 12 months. To determine the safety and efficacy of the drug. If the NDA is approved, the sponsoring drug company will almost immediately start marketing the drug. Although approved, a drug is still monitored for safety concerns. These post-market studies are often called phase 4 studies. To distinguish them from the pre-market clinical trials, if a drug is found to have previously unknown safety concerns, different actions are possible. The FDA could require modification of the prescribing information. Severe problems might require a boxed warning or black box warning on the drug's packaging. In rare instances, the drug's approval status may be revoked, and the drug will be pulled or withdrawn from the market. Collectively, data from preclinical and clinical trials provide evidence for regulatory agencies to determine whether a drug candidate is sufficiently safe and effective for use by patients. Completing clinical trials and being approved as a drug is a difficult challenge. Only approximately 10% of all molecules that enter phase 1 have a successful NDA.